Hey everyone, it's Jeremy here, bringing you another vlog. Today is July 17th, 2011, and I'm just grinding some wyvern bones so that I can make some super prayer potions. And if you look closely, you'll see that I'm wearing some Armadyl with my spectral. And that's because after I'm done making my super prayer potions, I'm going to be going to Armadyl. And we're gonna do our boss trip for the weekend there. I did try making a Bandos trip video last night, but me and my friend got crashed, and it was just annoying. So I decided to just go ahead and not show that video, and decided to switch it up and go to a different boss. And from past experience, not very many people go to Arma, so I don't think I'll have a hard time finding a world. At this point in time, I think I'll be soloing, but you never know. I might get a friend or two that at the last minute want to go with me. So I got back from Nicaragua on Thursday. I pulled into my driveway at around 5:30 a.m. and yeah, long trip. We left Nicaragua at around 10 a.m. So, lots of traveling, and I'm definitely glad to be back at home with air conditioning. But overall, I think it was a good trip, and I definitely would recommend anyone who hasn't been on a missions trip to do it. It will have its hardships, which this one had many. But overall, I know we did good. We did good things, and I know I came back a changed person, and I definitely want to go back again sometime soon. So, I kind of wanted to talk about some of the problems that we had while we were down there, and basically what happened was, the group of people from my church that went, it wasn't our trip, it was someone else's trip that we kind of asked to join. And so we were going to Nicaragua with a group of people that we did not know at all. And there was a very, very big personality clash between their leader and us as a group. So there was a lot of conflict between what should be done and what should not be done, and how things should be accomplished. And it definitely took a toll on us all for the first half of the week or whatever, but in the end we all got along and had an awesome trip. Part of the trip was we went to a waterfall and went swimming, and that was a lot of fun. Even though I lost my right contact at the waterfall, it was still so much fun, and I definitely want to do it again sometime. There's nothing like being able to swim right next to a huge waterfall. And I actually got a chance to swim through it. I went behind the water and swam straight through the middle of the waterfall. There wasn't any rocks below it, so it was fine. And let me tell you, I'm not a strong swimmer to begin with, but that was pretty hard. And yeah, I thought I was gonna die when I got through it, but I'm glad I did it. And then the next day, we went hiking through the Samoto Canyon or something like that, I think it's called. And it was about a 4-hour hike, and an hour of that was spent floating down a river with life vests and stuff. But apparently the water was too high this time of year to cliff dive, and so we had to, like, the original plan was to do a hike, go cliff diving off of 40 foot cliffs, and then like float through the river or whatever. But what we ended up having to do was a different trail, and then go up to like a lookout, a couple lookouts at the top of the mountain, and then climb down to the bottom of the mountain, and then float down the river. I did get a chance to do some cliff diving, but sadly it was just off of a big rock that was like a 10-foot drop, so that doesn't really count. But it was still fun, and those were the last 2 days. And at the canyon, I actually lost my left contact, so I couldn't see the entire way home. So that kind of gave me a headache, but it gave me an excuse to not drive, which is fine with me, because okay, so this is basically what we did for travel. We flew out of Nicaragua to Miami, and then in Miami we had to go through customs, and we had to take our bags off of the plane, we had to check them back into security, we had to go back through security ourselves, and then get on a plane to go to Chicago. And that was pretty stressful, and I was 5 minutes late to our plane because it took longer than expected at security. And thankfully I still made the plane, but I was 5 minutes late according to the boarding time, which is fine. I still had like another 15 minutes before the plane actually departed, so I had plenty of time. But from there, we flew to Chicago, and then at Chicago, we had to get on a charter bus and drive or ride in the bus for 3 hours. Sorry about that. Ride in the bus for 3 hours to about the Milwaukee area, and then in Milwaukee, that's where our vehicles were parked, and we had to pile in our vehicles and drive another 4.5 hours to get back to Eau Claire, where I live. And so it was a lot of travel, and if I were to do it again, I would not listen to the other group leader and meet them at their town and then drive to Chicago. I would fly right from the airport in our town and, you know, meet them in Nicaragua, because it was just so much travel and it was a pain. I'd much rather sit in an airplane for an extra 2 hours with the chance of not meeting up with them until a couple days after than to have to deal with that again, because it was just a pain. But overall, it was a good trip, and I'm glad I went. Going down to Nicaragua, it was pretty much the same deal with what we had to do, but instead of having to go through customs and stuff, all we had to... Why did I just do that? So we get to Milwaukee. Okay, we leave Eau Claire at noon. We get to the Milwaukee area around 4 or 5 o'clock. We pack all of our bags and stuff, and then we load into the charter bus at 7 o'clock and ride in the bus to Chicago. We get to Chicago at around 10:30 p.m. or so, which isn't that bad, but we can't check into our plane until 3 a.m. So we had to sit there. Oh shoot, I can't do this. I don't have my potions. Crap. I don't have mature green man in sales. I'll have to do this later. But so basically we had to sit in the lobby area of the airport of Chicago O'Hare Airport for 5 hours. And that was a pain. But I don't know. I guess we could have checked in, but American Airlines didn't have any employees working at the time, so we couldn't at the same time, which is annoying. But I'm gonna go over here. So basically we just had to wait there, and it was freezing in the airport. It was a lot warmer outside, so some of us went outside and chilled, and some of us just froze inside the airport. But 5 hours. That's a long time to just sit there in an airport because of stupid traveling plans. And I guess we had to take that bus at that time because that was the last bus that was leaving to Chicago. And I guess we had to fly out of Chicago because it was the cheapest flight they could find, which is stupid. I'd much rather pay an extra $100 or so to fly out of my town. But I guess that's just me. So at 3 a.m. we get everyone together. There was 13 of us. Yeah, there was 13 of us total. 7 of us from our church, and you know, the rest were from the other church. But 3 o'clock we check in, and they tell us that 3 of our giant shipping crates that we had stuff in could not be shipped. They said that according to the Nicaragua embargo, they were considered plastic bins and they would not allow them into the country. I don't know why, but that's what they said. And so we had to empty out those totes, and we had to shuffle the stuff into the rest of our bags, which we had 26 bags. We had 2 bags per person, and none of those bags were filled with clothes. They're all filled with shoes and t-shirts and Bibles. So we did that, and we ended up having to buy two duffel bags from the airline, which were the biggest ones that they had were tiny. They were so small. And Alex called me. Okay, so I'm making some super prayer potions now. Sorry, I had to go talk to Alex. But I wanted to show you guys this. I know this is kind of off topic of what I was talking about, but the logout trick works for stuff that takes like 14 to do or whatever. So if you wanted to do this for super prayer potions, it would work as well. And I didn't know that, but I knew that there was a couple people that commented and was wondering that. As you can see, it's still at 94, and it definitely saves you a lot of money with the green man ales, and I highly recommend doing it. And I completely forgot what I was talking about, but I just wanted to sum up my vlog by saying I'm back. I'll be back to my regular video schedule starting tomorrow. I will be putting this vlog up today, which is Sunday, and then tomorrow, and then tonight I'll also put up the Armadyl trip that I'm going to be going on, and then from there, oh crap, drank this stupid prayer potion, and then from there, just on Monday, tomorrow, I'll be making the Iron and Steel Dragon guide that I have been kind of putting off for a while. But I did get 95 magic last night, or actually no, this morning. I got it this morning. And so I can do the Fire Surge or whatever, the best Fire Wave spell in the magic spellbook. I can do that now. And that's what I was kind of waiting to do, or waiting on until I made the guy. Okay, so apparently, when I was recording my vlog, I got cut off at the end. So what I was talking about is the Steel Dragon guide, and I've been putting it off because I didn't have the magic level to do the fire surge spell. Let's see what it is. Fire surge spell. And I got 95 magic this morning, and so now I have the level required to do it, and steel dragons are highly weak to fire spells, and so that's a big way to A, train magic, and B, kill steel dragons. So I really wanted to include that in the guide, and then I will also show melee and range. Everyone should be happy with this guide, and that'll be coming out tomorrow. As for today, I will be uploading this vlog as soon as I'm done editing it, and then I will be trying to find a group of people to go to Armadyl, and if I don't, I will just solo it and get raped because I've never been to Arma. So hopefully it goes well. I've been watching some guides, and it looks relatively easy as long as you know what you're doing. But yeah, wish me luck, and I hope you have an awesome weekend, and we'll see you tomorrow. Peace.